Founding a Hackerspace for Beginners bei Lucaro and
King Barbecue
geblieben wäre. Und um die Vereins
and to make founding an association, a club, how to do it right. We invented two speakers for that. It's Torben Dittmar and Samuel Brinkmann, and both of them are organizing the Chaos Club in Flensburg. That's where they're from, and they want to tell us how to elect like the team and so on. So yeah, have a warm applause for them.
Yeah,
thanks. Welcome and a nice morning from us as well. Thanks that you're here, because our whole story starts with something like this, but on a different place. It was in Hamburg, and we have been to Congress, and this is so great here. Great people everywhere, there's cool projects, you can learn from each other, everything is blinking around. So that's exactly that's what we want in Flensburg as well. We want to take this home, that feeling. We don't want to have one time a year three great days, but but in best case every day. So that's how we took on our journey and to found the Chaos Treff Flensburg. That's us. So, and that's how it starts. So why should you found a club? And I think that's a really important question that you should ask in advance. For us, it was really clear. We want to have a hack space. It's like the name says, some space. So you need rooms, you need tools, you need shared projects. And it's great to have a registered association for that, because then you can pay rent commonly by collecting like a fee, and you can buy tools from that, and that's a cool way to organize that. And there's other great reasons to found an association. Maybe if you want to have a software project and want to support it financially. And the other thing is, if you want to have infrastructure, common infrastructure, then an association is the best way for that. But it should be clear that founding an association, especially in Germany, is connected to some work. It's not like you've done it once and then it's set up forever, but it's a continuous work, especially if you have more members. Then you need especially people who are caring for that important stuff. But let's start at the beginning. How to found an association, how to found a club. We have looked at the German example, and it's a bit more complicated. So that's our best of PowerPoint magic to make it as visual as possible. So the first step is, you need at least 7 people. To found an association in Germany, you need at least 7 people who are joining in. Tip of us, try to talk with the people in advance what they want to do, how to deal with decisions. Maybe there are some people who want to don't meet as often, or maybe do it a bit more exclusive. So you have to talk about these decisions as well. If you have 7 people, then you need like a foundation meeting. That's at least the first time to meet, and there needs to be a protocol. So someone needs to lead the meeting. So it's like a bit formal. And there's the second important thing. Yeah, you need like a formalization of the association, and you can say how the association is going to be led, and how meetings should go, and how decisions are made, and so on. And also what should happen if the association has to be left, and what if you leave the association, and how much the many members have to pay. And it's important that you're talking about this really at the beginning, and also have some ideas in advance. And then there's the big advance that you don't have to reinvent the wheel, but you can look at other associations, how are they organized. That's what we did. We said we wanted to, I don't know,
non-profit.
Yeah, we want to be a non-profit association, and we looked at other chaos traps, other hackerspaces, how they organize themselves and what their formal things and so on. So in your foundation meetings, you have to at least 7 people and to write a protocol, and you have to decide on that formal stuff, and that's valid for the association starting that day. And in that foundation meeting, you elect, yeah, head people, I don't know, and that's caring for the important stuff like your registration at the Amtsgericht in German, like the federal court. You can't just say we're 7 people, we are a registered association. No, you have to go with your formal things, with your protocol to a notary, and it's standard work for them. You just go there, or the leading people go there, and from that point on, the notary is caring for registering your association at the court. And if you're wondering how long that takes, from being at a notary to how long it just goes, you might have days, but it will rather take weeks, because it's all done by postal things in Germany. And another important thing you need when you want to found an association, you need an address, a post address, because all these official letters by the court and so on will go there. And that it doesn't mean that your new association needs rooms already. You just have to say what address your association has, but like our association is in Flensburg, but our postal address was like a post box for some time, which wasn't good, such a good idea, because you have to empty the post box regularly, and maybe you find the key sometimes, and then you're wondering, oh wow, what's that key for, and then you found letters from like weeks ago. So it's better to have a private address, and that just has to be someone who maybe reads or forwards those letters. And then if you get the feedback from the court, then you're done. Then you're a registered association. It didn't work so well for us the first time, because they said we had to change something. So maybe they say there's a formal mistake, and it's important to make ideas and think about that in advance. Okay, that's the Wizard's Association. So then everything is done you have to do, and you can make an applause to yourself, because that's work as well. Another thing you need afterwards, which is our tip, is like a folder where you can keep all the important stuff. You need a place where you have to collect all the documents you have for the association, no matter what it is, no matter if it's a protocol or something else. You have to collect it in some folder, because you need it later, and you have to keep it. And it's the easiest thing to do it in a folder. We have a solution with some other scanned document, but there's still a regular folder where you can put things in. And at best instructed, so the next person who has to look into that has easier work. But that's essential for the association, we noticed. And another thing you need is like a bank account. You can create a bank account for the association. That is important if you want to collect member fees, and then these member fees already go to the bank account. You can create a bank account at every bank, and there's like also special tariffs for associations and so on, but it's also possible online at the GLS bank or something like that. And in that matter, you have an association. All 7 people who have been in the foundation meeting are already members of the association, but you probably want more members. And that's important. So collect ideas at the foundation meeting. So one of you should create like a member formula, how you can get member in your association. And tip from us, if you could also have a SEPA area on that, so you can create like, you can collect money from the people, and you don't have to have people send you their money, so you don't have to watch out for that as much. And another thing is like
the other thing is the non-profitability of your association. That's the base, so people can donate money to you, and the person that donates can deduct it from his tax.
deutlich vergünstigt bekommt.
But that also means that there's a lot of other things as a registered non-profit association that you get things for free or that you get them for cheaper. Because we take care a lot of youth and we do technical education, but not every association has to be non-profit. Once you register your association, you're just an association, and then you have to go to the financial bureau, and they can make you a non-profit, and they will look at the reasons why you're doing the association, what's the reason behind it, and if people really profit from that. But the financial bureau can also say, well, that's not enough, you have to give us some more info about what you're doing. So the more you think beforehand, the easier it gets when founding it. And again, look at other associations, what are they doing, what are they saying, that why they're non-profit and why the public profits of it, it can help you find that out.
Dann natürlich halt auch gucken, wofür gibt er.
And once you're non-profit, you really have to see what you're spending your money for. You can't spend it for yourself or something like this. And it has to be really strict that this is really something you do for the public and for the association when you spend money.
Höher als bei dem normalen Verein.
And if and also for the financial bureau, you really have to prove that you spend the money the right way.
Wir haben das aber bis jetzt, glaube ich, schon quasi einmal bei der Gründung geschafft.
So, once we've registered the company, we made it, and also when going to the financial bureau, we made it, so it's not so hard to get. If you don't need really need it, you might not even have to go for it and register as a non-profit association. And once you've been founded, we look at some other positions in the club. There's a club meeting, so once you have the 7+ people, so you have to be to your contract, you have to do a club meeting every, so it's in our contract, it's written that we have to do this once a year. The CCC only does it every 2 years, and that's a little picture of the last yearly meeting we had. The yearly meeting is one of the most important things on the legal side that you do. So all the members that show up to that meeting, they elect the management of the club. And this yearly meeting is really for doing all the organizational stuff. You look at the money you spend, you look at the management of the club. You maybe look again at the non-profitability of the association, and you work on that. But in the end, all the members of the club, they together decide what this club is about, what this association this is about. Most of the clubs, they have the rules for that meeting written in the contract of the club, and so there has to be a minimum number of people present at these meetings, so you're ready to elect or do some major changes for the contract. So normally this is like a percentage of the people that have to be here, or it's a fixed number, and if these people don't show up, you can't make any changes to this. It's a very official thing to this meeting. Somebody has to write a protocol, you have to open the whole meeting. If there's an election, might be secret elections. So once the management changes, you have to really see how you the old people go and the new people come, and this all works together. And the management of the club, they really have to do more than the normal members of a club. So they also ask if they did everything right. You look to all the financial situation of the, you take the protocol, and in the end, all the papers will take in together. You put them into your folder, it's signed off, and again this goes to the notary, and the notary might have to do some changes if the management of the association changed, for example, and makes it then all valid. Well, and you as a member, you might have a lot of ideas what this club could do, how this could be changed, all the great things we could do, but you got to be careful. If you want to go not to the organizational stuff, but all to the little topics that your association wants to do, it might get too messy on that one meeting. And everything you talk about in that yearly meeting, in the special meeting, we'll get written down the protocol, and it's more paperwork and everything. So maybe the initial topics might be in a different, this might not be the right way to talk about these topics. And since our registration, if we have this yearly meeting, we invite all the people to it, and we close it, and then we close the meeting, and then we can also have some different talks, but they're outside of the normal meeting.
Von unserem ersten Vorsitzenden, wir nennen ihn gerne El Presidente.
But now I'll pass on to El Presidente, which is our first manager of the association. So what does the management of an association do? I made a slide, let's look at it. So that's what we do. At least what people imagine what being in the management looks like. In the end of the day, it's not that exciting. It's more boring. So in the contract again, it's written all the things that the management could do. You need at least three people in the management. You have a treasurer who takes care about all the financial situations of the club. And this is the hardest job actually in the management of an association. This person has to take care about the money, about the petty cash, where do we spend our money on, where do we get money, where there's the fees from the members of the club. You have to record where you spent the money for, and it's a lot of work, and it's a lot of tidy work. And each manager, there's two other members, at least two other members of the management. There's a second and the first management person. But the three of them together, they have the same rights. We're quite a small club, so we try to really limit the structures and the overhead that we get through this. So up to 500 euros, we have the decision that one person of the management can decide. If it's over 500, you need at least two reasons to keep the whole process simple. And we have a chat system where all the people of the chat of the club can talk about, and they see what's going on, and we put these things in the chat so everybody knows about what's going on. So if it's about opening a bank account or doing some changes to the register, again you have to look at the contract of the registration. So if you put your contract of the association on the contract, everybody can take a look at it and make sure that everything is right and how many people really have to come.
Genau. Das heißt, realistisch gesehen sitzt man halt häufig.
So most of the time you sit at the notary, you sit at the bank, and you get fed a lot of little sweets and everything. But and make sure that the paper is folded and put away right afterwards the right way so you find it again. And that's a lot of work you have to do. But it sounds funny, but it's work, you know. And the whole bureaucracy, somebody has to take care about it and make sure it is. So really think, you know, what are the right people of your club that are good for such kind of a position? It's a lot of responsibility that you have for the money being spent, so everything is properly done, it's properly recorded, so you need the right person for that. And we try to make it as transparent as possible, because we're just 30 members in our club, so that's quite easy, and so the management really has to make sure that the yearly meeting is done, the member meeting. But also members of the club might have asked for changes on the contract.
Yeah, I want to say sorry for the English people for this introduction to German bureaucracy. If you're still listening, then yeah, it's great. So, okay, you founded an association, so let's do a hackerspace, a maker place now. So most associations need rooms, after all. You want to make communities, you want to have workshops and maybe a social room where you can meet and exchange ideas and so on. We have regular meetings for that, and we said we want to have fixed rooms for that. And as an association, you usually don't have too much money, so Even in the smallest hackerspace, there's still room for the largest project. So here, as you can see, you can use like stairs as a workshop if you have not enough space everywhere else. If you're looking for rooms, then take your time. You'll probably find something. There's great partners for cooperation. So if you want to found a Kairostref, then maybe look if there's a hackerspace or a makerspace already that you can join in. If not, then talk to other cultural associations, other youth clubs. We are working together with cultural clubs, with the Danish cultural clubs and the Bonder on top. And yeah, it's cool to like feel if there's some associations you can do cooperations with. So for the most association, it's too expensive to rent own rooms at the beginning. So it's all about money. You should think about what you want to do with your club. Do you want to be public space, public meeting, regular meetings, and maybe want to meet for beer and pizza and make an event once a year? Then you can think, yeah, there's like small membership fees and a low entrance limit and so on. But if you're more to the point, you want to invest a lot of money in your tools, you want to have bigger rooms, bigger projects, more events, more than one event in a year, then you should think of saying your members to like spend more money and get donations and so on. So you have to say like you want to engage in this association, but you still want to pay. And we say that our membership fee is open to what the people are willing to pay. Many of them pay 10 euros, some more, some less, and at the end it's coming, more or less to zero. And what you want to do, you want to communicate on that, you want to have publicity, so you have to have a good communication model. And that's like what people think about, argue about often. Do you want to have a mailing list or chat tool like Rocket Chat or Slack? Or do you want to have a forum where you can talk on stuff? And yeah, that's your decision. That's depending on your group. We prefer chatting, other hackerspace prefer mailing lists. Maybe it was like a bit 90s stuff for us because we are more or less all young students, but try it out, try different technologies, and then you'll find something that fits to your needs, and then you have a great communication. And even if you just meet once a week regularly and many members don't have time every time, then yeah, we're already good in contact with all 30 members, and we're a good community and exchanging ideas and talking about your own projects and so on. So that you're not only yourself internet connected, but like maybe connect to other groups and other associations. There's a lot of hacker spaces and Chaos Computer Club. You're doing something right, you're in the Congress here. But what we also had to learn, there's more networking possibilities. So there's organizational possibilities for the treasury, for people like administering mailing lists, for people doing publicity. But in the Chaos Computer Club, there's also the regional meetings where the regional leaders meet 5 times a year to change ideas, to talk on what happens in the Chaos Computer Club, what do you want to work together on. And you can tune in there and, you can say, I want to work with them, and then you get a little bit deeper in the structures. The regional meeting has been already on this Congress yesterday, but go there, exchange ideas, talk about things, especially if you want to have a makerspace area. And furthermore, don't use too many tools. A mailing list, a chat, and a good calendar are probably enough to organize yourself, and then everything should work. If you have bigger projects, so we are a big fan of events. We are doing a lot of events per year. That's a small advertisement video for our last event, the Hacks on the Beach. There's a cool beach in Flensburg, and we can go there, work a bit. And events are great to bring a community together, because it connects your community, associations, your club, and people don't go to public meetings all the time, but it also connects those people who are interested in your stuff, maybe not being a member of your association yet. You can get cooperation there, and we have this mini hackerspace, mini Congress thing where you can provide workspace and exchange and some talks and some partying and stuff. Yeah, and having fun, a mini miniature Congress. And at your events, think about that they are a bit different, that they have your own little thing. We are going to the water because we are a maritime, but that's like a different atmosphere, being outdoors, outside, more interaction with the nature. Yeah, think of whom you can cooperate with. Another event that we are doing is the Tüfteltag, like experimenting days, together with the climate project. And beginning of this year, we had a small chaos events with around like 180 to 200 people. The usual stuff, hacking, talking, chilling, but at a different place with different people, with different peer groups, people who didn't know about us yet, new challenges, new location, and yeah, having fun with the device at the end of the day. To do such an event, what do you need? Not much. Two or three people who want to care about that, who are doing the project leading, maybe for the infrastructure, some people. So if you have a hackerspace, you want to have internet on your event, then your project leading should call someone who is caring for the internet at the end of the day, and the same goes for food and drink and what else needs. But at the end of the day, it's pretty easy to organize. And yeah, it's a good idea to talk to the people who are organizing the Congress, to talk to the angels. You don't have to have 4,000 angels to do such an event. 5 to 6 people are often enough as well. And yeah, there's a lot of fun with that. Maybe you need some coolness to stay cool, and let maybe take some small fee from your members. If you are a non-profit association, then you can make the bureaucracies thing easy, and our financial people can give you tips on that afterwards as well. Yeah, and with that, I just want to say have fun with the device and with the club, and create communities, create a clique. And I think it brought us good things in the last years, and we found new friends, and we are not thinking about stopping. So if you found such a club one time, then thing is running, and you can do it, even the financial stuff. That sounds evil, but if you're just talking to them, then it's also nice people there. Yeah, great. If there are any questions, Samuel is for you. Write emails, and we are here right after the talk, and we have some GitHub repository with some questions, Q&A, and best practice information. So if you are founding such an association, you don't want to know how a Webbit association works, but like rather a hackerspace, and yeah, there's information on that as well. Yeah, thanks for your attention.
Ja, danke nochmal auch von mir an Torben und Samuel.
Thanks a lot to the both of you. So, are there any questions? Microphone one, please. And the microphones are not on the video.
Positiv oder negativ, wenn wir keine Fragen haben? Ich glaube, wir haben es gut erklärt.
Is it good if they have no questions or isn't it good?
Nummer eins, bitte. Ich habe nur eine kurze Frage.
Just a short question from me. So going to the notary, you just went there and said, just one, I will have one association, or did you check it out before at some legal situation and stuff?
Yeah, there's multiple possibilities. So if you think you have like a lot of money and you want to have it managed by a notary, then you can have them do it. That's the service they offer, but I don't know how much it is, but it's probably more than some €100. If you just want to have a registration after the foundation meeting, it's like about 90 to 150, 40 euros. It was been like 130 euros for us, but it's like a one-time fee for registration. But they are helping you to correcting former mistakes, and maybe there's a signature missing, or you need to have a different formatting for a protocol, or something isn't quite clear yet. So they are looking through it with you, and common mistakes. If the election results aren't correct or aren't detailed enough, maybe it's a bit more expensive. But we informed ourselves as well. It's not so complicated if you just took like an afternoon or maybe even less to read through that stuff, and then you might get experts on how to manage a club, and you can just copy those stuff. And yeah, I think back then we oriented at other hackerspaces and other contracts of other clubs, and the backspace of Bamberg, we took a lot of stuff from them, so thanks to them.
Ja, cool. Herzlichen Dank nochmal an die. Ah, wir haben nochmal eine
Frage. Oh, there's one more question.
Ich wollte gerne wissen,
Hi. Wie Ihre I'd like to know, it's a two legal German legal terms, if you have a contract or association contract, and if there's any experience between the two types of contracts, and if you go to the notary, it's a contract association, all the changes have to be done through the notary. And so, should it not rather be like a normal contract and not the association contract? Because otherwise, every time you have to pay money, if the notary has to change it.
We had like very less constitutional changes yet, at least only one or two times when in our foundational membership meetings, we had to reduce the percentage of members needing to be there to have decisions, but you can do different contracts for financial stuff. Maybe that's important. So we don't set off financial stuff in our constitution, but in another piece of paper that's referenced by the constitution, because the constitution, it should be very short, so you don't have to change it that often. So is there a specific example where you say there are often changes?
No, we have a club, and I'm a member for 20 years now, and a lot of things like piled up of all the changes, and now it's a lot of work we will have to do, and for everything you have to pay money again and get money again, and if it's not the way that you thought it would be, and the notary said you have to check it again, so I thought maybe you have some experience in that area too.
So like financial membership fees contracts, you should keep it different, because then you can do different membership fees and so on without having to go to the notary, maybe a youth fee or something like that. So otherwise, if the room is changing, if you have to pay more for your rooms, then you maybe have to increase your fees as well. So the important thing at the constitution is that the constitution is the legal fallback thing. So that means if you are able to do it, then you should do much of the decisions and so on in the small area. And the constitution is then important if there's legal matters and if you're getting bigger, to have clearness there. And those topic things, so for being non-profit, you have to set a small focus on what topic you want to focus on. We have like popular education in the technology and so on, and that's like a very broad topic. You can do a lot of things on the topic, but the detailed topics are discussed by the members at the meetings.
There's one more question from the Signal Angel.
Ja, es gibt eine Frage aus dem Internet.
There's one question from the internet. What's the right URL? The URL you wrote there is not right. You just go to GitHub and search for
Chaos Drive Flensburg. It should work there. Interesting. We are going to find that out. It might happen that link is working after the talk afterwards. So maybe the repository is private or something.
One more question on microphone one. Hi. So there's a lot of responsibility you have if you have an association.
Wissen wir auch. Habt ihr euch Gedanken?
Did you think about if it would be without being an association or a registered association, is there maybe an easier way, or somebody in the audience who has some experience without this association structure?
So how does it look like if you're not a registered association? So what did you move to get a registered association after all, and not only just a gathering of people and making internal ethics and working with that? Yeah, an important reason why we founded an association was we wanted to rent rooms and tools that are used by the financial by the members of the club and also paid by the members of the club. And an association works like every person in the association has one vote, and not just a single one can decide everything, and you have like a bit of security on that. But on the other hand, if you can make like donations, accept donations if you are a non-profit, and you can get tools donated or money donated, and that's good for us. But if you are just like, we are 5-6 people and we just want to meet up for eating pizza regularly, then you might say it's too much work to found an association. Another thing might be that then it's like a registered association, that's what it's EV called in Germany, but there's the not registered association, so you don't get a registration. It's also complicated for German legal matters, but then you are like a more like a small company that everyone has to agree on everything, and you're using your money shared, but that makes other things complicated, because as an association you can go to the bank and get a bank account, and that's pretty easy because it's like quite popular, because there are many associations doing that. But and if you're saying it with just associations, then someone who is far away from the computer stuff, then I can accept that. Sport clubs as well, so you're a technical club, and I can understand that better if you're just then they're just a bunch of people. And also the whole Liga matters. When you start meeting with your friends and there's no clear structure, it's just in the room, then someone decides, well, we are association then, and he wants to get legal stuff with you, and then someone else say you're more like a small company. You can also found that by mistake, by accident, and then everyone is like responsible for that. So crowdfunding association is like a legal protection on that.
Ja, auch nochmal von mir. Herzliches Dankeschön. Herzlichen Dank an die beiden. Nochmal einen Riesenapplaus.
Dankeschön. Danke, dass wir das